Get ready. Holy Grail Barbecue's taking on the cheesesteak, and we're starting right now. Hey everybody, I'm Kevin.
I'm Claire.
And we're with Holy Grail Barbecue, where we teach you to cook like the pros using the latest equipment and techniques. So if you're looking to up your barbecue game, I invite you to subscribe down below. Philadelphia, the birthplace of our great nation and home of the Liberty Bell, William Penn, Ben Franklin, Rocky Balboa, the Eagles, and the Phillies. And the mecca for all hoagie lovers, Pats and Gino's.
That's right, everybody. We're making Philly cheesesteaks.
But we're not just going to cook these iconic steak sandwiches. We're going to redesign them.
What?
Get out!
There goes my college money.
Oh, come on, honey. It's going to be good. Philly girls. So the way I see it, the Philly cheesesteak is famous for both its simplicity and its flavor. Let's face it, it's blue-collar food for the most amazing sports fans around. So first we have the roll. One of the most important factors of the Philly cheesesteak is the roll. I believe it's one of the reasons why Big Hoagie hasn't conquered the Philly cheesesteak yet. All the mom and pop shops source some of the best bread around, and it's got substance, it's got texture. It holds up, unlike the big chains that have the worst bread available. Now, second, we have the iconic thinly sliced steak that's beat to death with a spatula on top of a cooktop. So we're definitely in our league with this one. We're gonna take it up Holy Grail barbecue style. Now, third and almost mandatory is the caramelized onion. These are gonna bring a nice sweet note to the savory beef. And of course, fourth, we have the cheese. Now, to be authentic, you gotta use Cheese Whiz. However, in recent years, provolone has made its appearance, and even American cheese. So for ours, we're gonna kick that up a little different. We're gonna take it to another level. So how exactly am I gonna redesign such an iconic sandwich? I'm about to show you. So here's the plan, barbecuers. This is going to be a two-grill cook. Now, if you don't have two grills, don't worry. I'll show you how to get through it without. So first up, let's get some smoky flavor on our beef. Down here, I've got, as you can see, already prepped with the perfect steak recipe. I've got two cuts of sirloin. Now, sirloin's pretty traditional for the cheesesteak. You could do ribeye, which would be oh so good. Just make sure it's quality steak. So I've prepped it up with the usual liberal amounts of salt on both sides, and it's been sitting for about a half an hour. In a moment, I'm gonna take this inside, rinse it off, and then we're gonna do the exact same perfect steak technique. I'm gonna do a light coat of avocado oil on each side, and then dust it with some pepper. So look how good those turned out once again. Nice dark color after doing the salt cure. And we're going to coat them with a little bit of avocado oil. Just a light coating. Right. And a little bit of pepper. And of course, both sides. What we're doing different for this is once they go into the pellet smoker and come up to 110 degrees and get that nice smoky flavor, I'm pulling them off and I'm putting them in the freezer. Why? Because I want to get those things firm enough to get razor thin slices of the beef. All right, let's get them on the grill.
Thank you.
for the rolls, we're gonna do a garlic mustard aioli. Let's take care of that now. Got about a tablespoon of mayo. And then to that, we're gonna add about a teaspoon of mustard. And of course, salt and pepper to that. Then we're gonna add just a little bit of garlic powder. And that's gonna be a great addition to the rolls. Now let's start prepping some veggies. Some green bell peppers and a yellow onion. So I'm just gonna have peel and thinly slice the onion. Now what I do like to do for the bell peppers is trim this little waxy area here. Not necessary, personal preference. I think it helps with presentation. Then let's just slice these thin. I think one more section should do it. There we go. Ain't nothing better than the combo of onions and peppers on a steak. Okay, so now before these go onto the grill, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit them with a light coating of olive oil, salt and pepper, and then get them onto a cooler part of the grill so that they cook nice and slow. We don't want overcooked onions or peppers. We just want them to slowly caramelize. So into the bowl, and we're going to hit them with a light coating of olive oil and of course salt and pepper. Do you like fried onions on your cheesesteak? Do a hashtag yes or hashtag no down in the comments below. So what's better with a cheesesteak than a side order of fries? So that's what we got going on here. I've parboiled these russet potatoes. That took about 10 minutes. Set them in a pot with cold water. Bring them up to a boil. At that point in time, start counting your 10-minute timer. By the time that's done, they're very soft, not quite cooked all the way, but ready to take on some great flavor from the grill. Now, when we put these on the grill, I'm gonna coat them with a little bit of olive oil, salt and pepper, of course, put them on the hot part of the grill. We want them to cook fast because I want a nice crispy outside, tender on the inside. We got a lot of them, but we made it in the bowl. Salt, a little pepper. I think I'm gonna change it up a little bit and add some of my fry seasoning. Now, if you don't already have it, I'll leave a recipe for a Holy Grail barbecue rub down in the comments below. All right, let's get these on the hot part of the grill. So here's our steak. After being on the pellet smoker and coming up to about 110, I missed the mark a little bit. I was at 112 degrees once I pulled them off. Not bad. It's not going to matter at this point, because what we're going to do is I'm going to take these and I'm going to put them into just some plastic. You can put them in plastic wrap. I'm just going to put them into Ziploc because it was easy and convenient. Then I'm going to throw these in the freezer. In 15 to 30 minutes, they're going to be just firm enough to get some nice thin slices.
Gorgeous cover on these.
So the potatoes are almost done. Let's get a nice sauce for them that's going to complement the aioli that we're going to put on the rolls. So let's start with a little bit of our Dijon mustard again. About a tablespoon. And then we're also going to add some of your old style Dijon mustard. Still got a lot of the seeds in there. Give it a nice little texture. Of course, a little bit of pepper, a little bit of salt, and to that, a little white wine vinegar, not a lot. And some extra virgin olive oil. Key there, we're making a vinaigrette, right? So the key there is you want to balance the acid and the oil. So equal parts. Great sauce.
Look at those. Perfect. Thank you.
while the sirloin's getting nice and firm in the freezer, let's make a sauce that we're gonna use when we go ahead and do the final cook of the beef. Starting with a quarter cup of water. And I've showed you these before. Love them. They are beef stock packets that are concentrated in this little package. Add them to water, you got beef stock that's fresh. One of the problems I always have with beef stock and is that you buy this gigantic container of it and you don't use it as often, so that it eventually goes bad and you waste a bunch. With these things, you don't waste anything. So, got a quarter cup of beef stock there. And then to it, keeping with our theme, we're gonna add just a little bit of our mustard. I'll make sure to leave a link for these in the comments below. Okay, so our steaks have chilled in the freezer for about 15-20 minutes. They're pretty firm now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just take them and slice them against the grain, nice and thin. Need a really sharp knife to do this. Using the freezer technique is key. Otherwise, you could never get the thin slices that you want unless you have some professional equipment like the butchers have. But look how thin that's coming out. Look how perfect that is. Just absolutely the way you want your cheesesteak beef to come out. Towards the end here, it's curling up on me a little bit, so I might not be able to get as thin as I want. Not bad. So against the grain for this one as well. Look, I mean, look how paper thin those can be made just by using that freezer technique. Okay, it's time to get this on the grill. We're gonna go over and we're gonna put this onto a very, very hot skillet. Let this crisp up nice and brown. We're gonna put it down and just leave it there. Once we get a nice caramelization on the beef, we'll flip it over, let that side get a nice caramelization on it. We'll add then the sauce that we made, let that give it some flavor. Then we'll make it into piles and put some of the veggies that we caramelized up that are looking so perfect. We'll stack those on top with some cheese and get the buns ready. Now, I know my choice of cheese here is gonna throw you off, but once again, we're going all out on this one, right? I'm using cheddar. Cheddar cheese and beef go really well together. In addition, I'm gonna add some pepper jack cheese, which is gonna take it to the next level. This is all about layering flavors. So there you have it, folks, the culinary blue-collar classic, the Philly cheesesteak. Will it replace the original? Well, no. But we can say that ours came out pretty darn good. And it may just get me back in the house tonight.
Daddy, does this mean I get to go to college?
Absolutely.
Subscribe and hit the little bell and hit the thumbs up button.
Hey, Daddy. How about if we put the kids to bed early tonight, if you know what I mean?
I love it when a plan.